Many of you may have seen video like this yesterday. People lining up to vote over in Wisconsin in the middle of a national health crisis. There was a court battle over in-person voting, but the courts ruled the primary should go on. Now, you might wonder, what kind of plans are in place here in Michigan with two elections looming? Local 4's Paula Tutman put together a panel of experts and got some answers for us.
On the video conference call, Macomb County Clerk Fred Miller, Oakland County Clerk Lisa Brown, representing Wayne County Clerk Kathy Garrett, whose brother unfortunately passed away, Lisa Williams Jackson, Detroit City Clerk Janice Winfrey, Rochester Hills Clerk Tina Barton, Roseville Clerk Richard Steenlin, Sterling Heights Clerk Melanie Riska. Already, your local and county clerks are putting together COVID contingency plans.
We stand ready to make certain that the election process is not compromised and that democracy will prevail.
Each clerk had the same reaction when they saw the video of those long lines in Wisconsin yesterday.
Frightening. It's frightening to see. First of all, people shouldn't have to wait that long to vote.
If we were to have precincts open, we've already looked at sneeze guards to put in place, acrylic guards that we could put in place at the precinct if we had to, that would protect the precinct workers, the gloves, the hand sanitizers, the masks.
Paramount that Lansing act now, not later, in giving clerks the tools they need to reach voters and to efficiently count the vote.
I think it is imperative for our legislature to revisit the notion of allowing us to process or at least open AV ballots early.
The biggest joint problem, a bipartisan agreement that disinformation and misinformation campaigns to dampen trust in the process be stopped.
That every single application that comes in for an absentee ballot, we're checking the signature on the application. And when that ballot is returned to us, we're checking that signature a second time.
We're not reinventing the wheel. We have states, we have big cities that do vote by mail. And all we have to do is look what they're doing.
I think that one principle that we absolutely cannot let go of is adherence to a paper ballot, whether it be voting at the polls or voting absentee. We must maintain that paper ballot.
Our recent primary with same-day voter registration and a focus on absentee ballots was an unwitting dress rehearsal, as Secretary of State Jocelyn Benson indicated in an earlier interview.
We are really one of the only states in the country where voters demanded the right to vote by mail.
We will administer a safe election. It's important to us that our voters are not afraid to vote, that they don't feel that they will be jeopardizing their health in order to vote.
Obviously, I think that we need to go, communication, get people to realize the benefit and the ability to vote absentee and minimize the personal contact.
Wow, big thanks to all of those clerks who joined me this morning. Really a worthwhile conversation. We're going to post the whole thing. It's about 35 minutes on our social media platforms, and click on Detroit.com. Important information for your district, Karen.
All right, a very important conversation. Thank you so much, Paula. Right now-